My name is Winfried Deckelmann from Lynx Technik AG. I'm the CEO of that company. Lynx Technik AG is a company based in Germany, specializing on modules for signal processing. We currently are introducing a new range of products called the Green Machine. Green Machine is not just a product, Green Machine is a new concept for the broadcast industry. Green Machine is completely different from a concept point of view. So Green Machine, first of all, separates the signal processing from the physical IOs. Means we have a separate processor inside the Green Machine, which is this box, where the processing is done on a special processor, which can be removed from the box, and all the processing is done in that processor. The I.O. board inside here just takes the signals coming in and out and splits it up in elementary streams so that the processor can manipulate and process all the data, means video, audio, and metadata individually, and provide all the functionalities for the customers. The processing itself is based on an app concept, on a very flexible app concept, means a customer can program the unit according to his own needs. The basic hardware is at a very low price level. The basic hardware does almost nothing. What it does is it provides input outputs and preview functionality. The rest is done through a very clever app concept. The whole machine can be controlled from the front control panel, but more conveniently through a very clever, flexible graphical user interface, which allows you to define the configurations of apps, loading of apps into the Green Machines, and modifying the Green Machine. The Green Machine can always be reprogrammed according to the current needs of the customer. Means you can have a different function in the morning and reprogram the machine in the afternoon. For example, you have an OB van, you go on site, you have to test your installation, you need a test pattern generator and an analyzer. You program the Green Machine according to that one. In the afternoon, you go live, you need a frame synchronizer, and an up-down cost converter, you just reprogram the Green Machine, and you have the same box with different functionality. You save space, you save energy, you save cost for the hardware. What you also can do with many multiple Green Machines in a network is that the Green Machines share the apps, the available apps. So when you have an app on one Green Machine, you can use the same app at a different time on a different Green Machine. Means you need up-down cost conversion in the morning on Green Machine A, in the afternoon on Green Machine B. You just move that app from Green Machine A to B according to the need you have over time. We are providing different versions of the hardware box with different interfaces, but as I said, the processor itself is the same, so you can use the same apps on different hardware versions. Currently, we provide two different hardware versions, means a box with two channels, with two SDI inputs and outputs, plus fiber, plus HDMI, etc., and a four-channel device. The four-channel device is shown the first time here at NAB, what we call the Green Machine Titan. The Titan provides four channels of processing, so this is the ideal unit also for 4K processing. It can be used as a four-channel 3G device or a single-channel 4K device. It adds to the four 3G interfaces also a single-link 12G interface, where you can put out and take in 12G single-link signals for UHD, 4K, or even you can transport four independent 3G signals over a 12G fiber interface. We think that we are the first company providing single-link 12G over fiber. There are not so many companies offering the same or having the solution already available at the current time. Later this year, we will also provide IP versions. In case of Green Machine, this is not a big difference. So what is the difference of IP versus SDI? It's just a physical interface. So we will provide another box which will add a 10G Ethernet interface where you can then transmit your signals also via a 10G interface, and we will provide either compressed streams or uncompressed streams over 10G. As I said, this will be shown towards end of this year, and introduction will be at IBC in Amsterdam.